Evan Lazar here reporting from Gillette Stadium for CLNS Media, and in this video we are going to break down the keys to victory for the Patriots defense against the Saints offense. We also have a video on Mac Jones and the Patriots offense's keys to victory against a pretty good Saints D, but let's start with Jameis Winston, Alvin Kamara, and the Saints offense. And if you're the Patriots, and the theme of the week talking to Patriots head coach Bill Belichick and the players in the locker room is covering up weaknesses. These are two teams that don't know each other very well. It's been four seasons since they last played in 2017, so you're not going to cram the entire Saints playbook and prep for the entire Saints offense into just a couple of days in 1 week. So what the Patriots have to do is look internally within. What are our weaknesses, and how might Sean Payton, a game plan coach, look to expose them? And that brings us, of course, to a run defense that gave up 152 yards on the ground last week to the New York Jets. And when you have a running back like Kamara and a pretty good Saints offensive line, you look at that as a clear strength for New Orleans against a weakness of the Patriots. And the scheme I specifically want to talk about in this video is outside zone. Since the beginning of 2020, the Patriots ranked 27th in the NFL against stopping outside zone run blocking schemes. The scheme where the offensive line is going to step out towards the sideline and run horizontally across the field and try to set up those cutback lanes for the ball carrier. And where do the Patriots' problems lie in outside zone? Last year, it was mostly with setting the edge. The edges have looked better this season, but those interior defensive linemen got pushed off the ball against New York, and Devon Godshaw, Christian Barmore a few times got caught up the field, and they need to get down the field or vertical into the backfield of the Saints, getting pushed off the line of scrimmage, trying to flow side to side with the offense. That's exactly what they want you to do. That's how you set up those cutback lanes. That's how they gash you for big yardage. So if you're the Patriots defensive line in this game against Kamara and the Saints, you have to get up the field, you have to penetrate, and you have to push them back and make sure you stop that running game. Why? Jameis Winston, although he's had some good moments and certainly some highlights in week one, especially in the red area, the pressure gets to him. And in a traditional drop back passing game where the Patriots can force Winston into second and third and long and really unlock that pressure package, Winston's passer rating plummets to 41.3 while he is under pressure. His PFF grade against the blitz is 28.6 through two games. So if the Patriots can get Jameis Winston into a traditional drop back passing game, apply the pressure on the Saints quarterback, he is still prone to turnovers. He is still prone to just bad plays against pressure, and he is less effective when the pocket is dirty versus when he is kept clean. So that's the key for the Patriots, stopping that Saints rushing attack and Alvin Kamara. Will also break down the matchup in the passing game against Alvin Kamara in our key matchups video on our YouTube channel, Patriots Press Pass, and you can read my Patriots game plan previewing Pat Saints on Sunday here in Foxborough on clnsmedia.com. I'm Evan Lazar for CLNS Media. Thanks for watching. CLNS Media's Patriots coverage is brought to you by the Legends brand. High performance apparel with style and comfort that you will want to wear all day long. Use the promo code PATS20 for 20% off your first order. That is legends.com.